umuntu okholwa
that somebody believes according to the scriptures
phakathi
inside of their belly
kugobhoza imifula
flows the rivers
yamanzi moya lo ingcwele
the Holy Spirit
we are not going to spinise
the one who gives assurance
uthethe ukholwa
that if God
okuyibona kona
the real faith
moya lo ingcwele
Holy Spirit
we are not going to assurance
gives us assurance
ukuthi sithandiwe sikhethiwe
we are chosen by the heavens
singabantwana
we are the children of the Most High God
sizindlalifa
we are the heirs of heaven
khuluma ngomoya lo ingcwele
talk about the Holy Spirit
never fails mudimo ha ahlulehi uNkulunkulu akahlulwa uzimo akabhalelwa shikwembu ashihluleni
you are going to the word of God
in
the name of Jesus
ake sifunde niqhubeke nendaba engikhuluma ngayo
kule continue with my message of these days
indaba kamoya loyingwele
the message of the Holy Spirit
ngokuba lesikhathi esiphila kuso
the time that we are living in
isikhathi sika moya loyingwele
the dispensation of the Holy Spirit
asivumele umoya ingwele
let us allow the Holy Spirit in our lives
asivumele umoya ingwele
let us allow the Holy Spirit
emabandleni
in our churches
athi take control
athathe indawo
ahambe ngendlela afuna ukuhamba ngayo
and do whatever he pleases
asebenze ngendlela afuna ukusebenza
ngayo and work the way he likes
ngoba isikhathi sika moya
loyingwele the time of the Holy Spirit
isikhathi sika moya loyingwele
the time of the Holy Ghost
isikhathi sika moya loyingwele
time of the Holy Spirit
uma singamvumela
if we allow him
umoya loyingwele
the Holy Spirit
kuzokwenzeka isimanga
miracles will happen
elithi izwi likaNkulunkulu
what of God says
ekuqaleni
in the beginning
uma uNkulunkulu edala umhlaba
when God created the heavens and the earth
elithi izwi likaNkulunkulu
the Bible says
there was darkness
kwakunobumnyama
over the surface of the earth
phezukodwa
and the Bible says
and the Bible says
the spirit of the Lord
moya kaNkulunkulu
wow
hamba hamba
over the waters
phezukamanzi
kuleso simo
in that situation
moya kaNkulunkulu
the spirit of the Lord
wow hamba hamba
was moving
ngithi mina ke simvumele
let us allow him
moya kaNkulunkulu
the Holy Spirit
nakulesimo esinzima
in this difficult situation in the whole world
where
COVID has attacked
ake simvumele umoya ingcwele
let us allow the Holy Spirit
uma umoya ingcwele hamba hamba
when the Holy Spirit moves
kuzonqotshwa lokufa
this death will be overcome
kuzonqotshwa leli demon
this demon will be defeated
ake simvumele umoya ingcwele
let us allow the Holy Spirit in our churches in our lives in our homes let him move around heal us liberate us read with me
in the book of Acts
chapter 8
from verse number 14
from verse 14
to verse number 17
from verse 14 to 17 the book of Acts
chapter 8 verse number 14
from verse 14
to verse number 17
verse 17
now when the apostles
Wathi kubaba apostoli
which were at Jerusalem
base Jerusalem
heard that Samaria
bezwe ukuthi Samaria
received the word of God
lilamukele izwi kaNkulunkulu
they sent unto them Peter and John
bathumela kubo uPetro noJohane
when they were come down
sebehlele khona
prayed for them
baba khulekela
that they might receive the Holy Ghost
ukuba bamukele umoya ongcwele
for as yet he was fallen upon none of them
ngokuba wayengakehleli nakweyedwa kubo
only they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus
kodwa babaphathizwe egameni leNkosi uJesu
then laid their hands on them
kwana bababeka izandla phezukwabo
and they received the Holy Ghost
base bamamukela ke umoya ongcwele
babeka izandla phezukwabo
they laid hands upon them
base bamamukela umoya loyingcwele
and they received the Holy Spirit
babeka izandla phezukwabo
they laid hands upon them
base bamamukela umoya loyingcwele
and they received the Holy Spirit
lapho sifunda khona
where we just read
lithizwi likaNkulunkulu
the word of God says
wathuma abapostoli
when the apostles
heard ukuthi Jerusalem bezwa ukuthi Samaria
that Samaria
balamukele
had received
izwi likaNkulunkulu
the word of God
balamukele
had received
ivangeli likaJesu
the gospel of Jesus
balamukele
had received
izwi likaNkulunkulu
the word of the living God
izwi likaNkulunkulu
thus says the Lord
basebethumela
and they sent
uPetro
Peter
noJohane
and John
lithizwi likaNkulunkulu
the Bible says
ngokuba njengalokho bemamukele uJesu
as they received Jesus
belamukele izwi likaNkulunkulu
received the word of God
umoya loyingcwele
Holy Spirit
kadanga kehleli
phiswa
ingakho lithi izwi likaNkulunkulu
that's why the Bible says
bathumela abapostoli
they sent the apostles
ukuthi mabahambe bayobakhulekela
must go and pray for them
ukuthi bamukele
to receive
umoya loyingcwele
the Holy Spirit
bamukele
to receive
umoya wamandla
spirit of power
umoya weqiniso
spirit of truth
umoya loyingcwele
the Holy Spirit
noma kade bekholwe kuphela
but they only believe
egameni likaJesu
in the name of Jesus
umoya loyingcwele
the Holy Spirit
kade bengakamamukeli uyabona ukuthi kubalulekile
it is very important
uma sewumamukele Jesu
after receiving Jesus
uma futhi ukubhabhathiswa
allow to be baptized
umoya loyingcwele
with the Holy Spirit
mamukele umoya loyingcwele
you receive the Holy Spirit
uma ukugcwaliswa
be filled
ngamandla
with the power
kamoya loyingcwele
of the Holy Spirit
uma ukugcwaliswa
allow to be filled
ngamandla
with the power
asezulwini
or from high
elithi izwi likaNkulunkulu uthi Jesu mina ngisa
say I am the gate
uma umuntu engena ngami
if someone comes in
uya kusindiswa
will be saved left,
angene,
come in,
aphume,
and come out,
nijero,
and find the pastors. That's how you say
it.
Does not enter the gate.
We're
going through Jesus.
We
receive Jesus as the Lord and Savior. But you go in. We need people that are going to go in into the things of God. We need people that are going to lodge in to the power of the Holy Spirit. The word of God says, until you find the pastors. In other words, until you find your gift that you will serve within the church, that you're going to serve the body of Christ. Find the pastors. Find your gift. All this happens
to
the people that understand. Does not end in receiving Jesus. When you have received Jesus, you go into the things of God until you find your gift. Just say, set up the gate. When you come to me, you will be saved. Go in and you find the pastors. Talk about the message that is very important. The message of this, of the Holy Spirit, Spirit of power, Spirit of truth. Word of God says, the Holy Spirit testifies together with our spirit that we are the children of the Most High God. The Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the Father, the Spirit of power, we are fagaselana
with our spirit, assuring us that we are children of God. The Spirit
of the Lord gives us assurance, gives us assurance that we are the children of God. In other words, if you don't have the Spirit of the Lord, the Holy Spirit, you don't have the assurance that you're a child of God. The Holy Spirit is the one who assures you, is the one who gives you assurance that you're a child of God. In other words, if the Holy Spirit has not come into your life, your salvation is questionable. You don't have assurance. There was everybody who came to be a child of God. Everybody says they are children of God. But the word of God says, Holy Spirit testifies together with our spirit. He assures us that we are the children of the Most High God. That's why the word of God says, God knows those that are His. How does He know them? The word of God says, those who don't have the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of the Lord, is not of God. You can call yourself that I'm a child of God. You're of God. You don't have the Holy Spirit. You're not of God. The word of God says, we have put a seal of the Spirit of the Lord. We have the mark. The Holy Spirit is our mark in our lives. In other words,
the presence of the Holy Ghost is a mark
in our lives
that we belong to God. The word
of God says,
we have been sealed for the day of redemption.
We put out a seal by the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the mark. When the Bible says that God knows they that are His, He knows them by the mark. We've got the mark. How does He know them? By the mark. That is the Holy Spirit. That's why it is important. When
they
receive Jesus, be worried. Allow to be filled. Allow to be baptized by the Holy Spirit. Read the book of Acts,
chapter 10,
from verse 44. The Bible says, when Peter was preaching, as he was speaking his words, the word of God, those who were hearing it, the word of God, the uncircumcised, the Gentiles, the Holy Spirit came upon them. The Holy Spirit came upon them. The Bible says, the uncircumcised, the Jews, were surprised. Does the Gentiles also receive the Holy Spirit like us? Peter said, what is it denying us that these be baptized? Because also they have received the Holy Spirit. The Jews were thinking that the Holy Spirit only comes upon them
bangala.
They were surprised when they saw the Holy Spirit come upon the Gentiles. They were surprised when the Holy Spirit came upon the circumcised. Indeed,
even
the circumcised are loved. They are chosen. They are chosen by the heavens. They are loved by God. The Holy Spirit came upon your life. Gives you assurance.
It
gives you the assurance that even you are a child of God. You are chosen by the heavens. But happened, your salvation has been doubted because of your past, things you went through. But happened, the gospel took you from far. But happened, you are a killer. But happened, you are a witch. But happened, you are doing miserable things that we cannot say on air. But the gospel found you. You received Jesus as the Lord and Savior. Yes, you are a believer, but you doubt. The devil is saying to you, God cannot forgive you because of the sins of the things that you committed. But I want to assure you, until the Holy Spirit comes upon your life, that's where you're going to have assurance that I'm also, my sins were forgiven me, that also I'm chosen by the heavens. Even though the devil wants to remind you of your past, wants to remind you of the evil things that are coming from, you've got no fear. You tell the devil happily and laughingly, say, the devil, my sins are forgiven, I'm chosen, I'm loved by the heavens. When the devil asks you, where do you get that assurance? You get it from the Holy Spirit, the coming down of the Holy Spirit upon your life. The baptism of the Holy Spirit gives you assurance, gives you assurance that you're a child of God. You are chosen by the heavens. The Holy Spirit is a seal in our lives. You need the Holy Spirit, the time of the Holy Spirit. Just saying, on the great day of the last day of the feast, the Bible says Jesus stood up and he said, is there anyone who is thirsty? Let him come and drink. Just saying, he believes in me according to the scriptures, outside of their belly shall flow the rivers of living waters. The Bible says Jesus was talking about the Holy Spirit that they will receive right inside of their belly, shall flow rivers of living waters. Just saying, he who believes in me according to the scriptures. Everyone says that I'm a believer. Everyone says I'm a believer.
Especially
South Africa. It's known as a believer's country. The Bible says, just saying, he that believes in me according to the scriptures. That's what you see. That the real faith and if you have the real faith, just say in your belly, shall flow rivers of the living waters. Talk about the spirit of the Lord that will receive.
That is why
you must check your faith. Did you believe according to the scriptures? Everybody says that I'm a believer. Everyone says I'm a believer. But somebody believes according to the scriptures, inside of their belly flows the rivers. In other words, the Holy Spirit is the one who gives you assurance that if God, the real faith, the Holy Spirit, God gives us assurance that we are loved, we are chosen by the heavens, we are the children of the Most High God. We are the heirs of heaven. Talk about the Holy Spirit. Talk about the Holy Ghost. Talk about the Spirit of the Lord. When Jesus spoke about it,
he is the comforter. He is the counselor.
The Word of God says,
we don't know how to pray, but the Holy Spirit intercede for us with groanings that cannot be uttered.
Talk about the Holy Spirit.
You're
saying, I'm going to my Father.
But
when I get to heaven, I'll ask the Father to send you another comforter, the Holy Spirit. When he has come, he will teach you all things and lead you into all truth. Viewers at home, listeners at home, of the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ fulfilled his ministry on earth. He finished it. He went up, went to heaven. Jesus, when he rose from the dead on the third day, Jesus, he lived for 40 days to prove to the world that he never stole it, but he rose. The word of God says, Jesus Christ ascended. All the eyes were seeing him. All the eyes were watching Jesus. He ascended. And the voice came
from above.
The way he went up is the way he's going to come down. And Jesus is coming. When he went up, he said, I'm going to heaven, to the Father. Jesus said, I'm going to ask the Father to send the Comforter, the Helper, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. When he's come, he will comfort you. Whatever situation you are facing, when he's come, he will teach you, he will lead you into all truth. When he's come, you need this help. Don't know the situation that you are facing. I don't know the situation that you are in. But the Holy Spirit is the only one who has got the power to help you. What of God says,
it is not by might,
I'll sing a man,
it is not by power,
but
by the Spirit of the living God. And it is
what of God says,
when an enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord raises the standard. That is why
called that is filled by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Move from power to power, from glory to glory.
It's the time of the Holy Spirit. Let us allow the Holy Spirit in our churches, in our lives. Let us allow him. Let us allow him. Let us allow him. Let us allow him. Where we just read, what of God says, what of God says, when the apostles, when they heard that Samaria has received the word of God, what of God says, the Holy Spirit, he didn't come upon them. It does not end in receiving Jesus. When people have received Jesus, they must be baptized with the power of the Holy Spirit. They are baptized in the name of Jesus when they receive Jesus.
Number two,
they are baptized with the Holy Spirit. The apostles came. Peter and John. They prayed for them. For them to receive
the
Holy Spirit. What kills us these days in our churches, that in churches, the message of the Holy Spirit is no longer spoken of. It is the message of the Holy Spirit. We don't take it seriously. People are saved.
Six months
without having heard of the Holy Spirit for the year, even 3 years without having heard of the Holy Spirit, they end up just going to religious in churches. But having received Jesus, the Holy Spirit,
they
didn't come into their lives because the leaders don't take seriously the message of the Holy Spirit. They end up
claiming
the things of God. They end up imitating the things of God. You may think that they are filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. No, they are claiming it. The Holy Spirit is going to come upon them. The Holy Spirit will come upon them how? If they are not taught, if they
are
not speaking about the Holy Spirit in our churches, don't pray for people to receive the Holy Spirit. How is it going to come down? The time now. Let us be like the church of the apostles, people that just received Jesus. They were never making a mistake. They make sure that they pray for them, that they receive the Holy Spirit. If you check, there's the games in the churches, many evil things in the churches,
It is because umoya
the Holy Spirit
taking
my time.
Umoya
Holy Spirit,
we see experience.
We're going to experience when with
carnality,
but we are praying.
We are
apologizing in
the mighty name of Jesus.
That's why we are praying like David, asking God not to take away, not take him away. That's the Holy Spirit. We are praying also. We are saying, Lord, do not take away your spirit from our lives. Don't take away your spirit from our churches. Things are better
because
the Holy Spirit is no longer taking
serious.
The Holy Spirit has been closed out. Programs continue. We will go carnally. We stick to the Holy Spirit in our churches. We don't allow him, the Holy Spirit, in our churches. That's why it is bad.
But
check the churches. Even the
salvation
is no longer there. People fellowship with things. They fellowship with hatred. They fellowship with gossip. There is no more confession. They are promiscuous right in churches. They sing promiscuous. They do everything in churches. The Holy Spirit is no longer there. The Holy Spirit is no longer there. People are living anyhow. The time of the Holy Spirit, when you are preaching, if you are never talking well, the Holy Spirit will convict you. He will speak to you alone and he will cry tears and say, what were you saying? How did you look at that brother? How did you teach the other brother? The work of the Holy Spirit.
We're
praying for one thing: restoration of the Holy Spirit in our churches, in our lives. When we want to see God working, when we want to see miracles happening in our lives, it will happen when you allow the Holy Spirit
to take control.
The Holy Spirit
move
around the way he desires in our churches and work the way he wants in our lives. Without him, we cannot do anything. Need the Holy Spirit. May he come to churches. May he come to churches. We need the Holy Spirit. If you read this
from
message,
verse number 5,
from verse 5, the Bible says,
Philip
went down to Samaria and he preached there.
Christ.
In Samaria, a man full of the power of the Holy Spirit, a man filled with the power of heaven, the power of the Holy Ghost, preached the gospel,
pushed
by the power of the Holy Spirit, preached Christ in Samaria. The Bible says, the people of Samaria heard, they saw the miracles and the signs that Philip did. The Bible says the sick were healed.
Those
who were demon possessed, they came out of them. The word of God says the crippled began to walk. Miracles happened.
There was a great joy in the city of
Samaria. In that place, there was a witch doctor. There was a sangoma. There was a man called Simon. The Bible says he was in charge of Samaria. The people of Samaria were following him. So it's the great power of God.
He
was followed by crowds. But he was not using the power of God.
He
was not using the power of the Holy Spirit. He was using the power of darkness. People were following him. He was shaking the people of Samaria. But a man came that preaches the gospel that is not mixed with anything. A man came that preaches the gospel that goes with the power of the Holy Spirit. Miracles happen when the Holy Spirit is there. Signs and wonders happen. That's why one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit is the gift of the miracles.
It's
the gift of healing. When the Holy Spirit is there in the churches, is there in our lives, miracles will happen. When you see miracles no longer there in the churches,
it's because
the Holy Spirit, we have taken him, put him aside, continue with our experience, continue with carnality. But if we can allow you, the Holy Spirit,
we
will see miracles. The dead will rise, miracles will happen. The Bible says,
Samaria.
People repented in Samaria. People moved away. From this witch doctor, from this Simon, they stuck with Jesus. They received Jesus. They believed. The Bible says, even this witch doctor, even this Simon, when he saw people repented, he also repented. He received Jesus.
Because when the power
meet
the power, the lesser power must bow. When the power meet the power, the lesser power must bow. This man
people from
miracles
are happening, but using the difference
of power,
we see him repenting, giving himself to Jesus. Because of the gospel of Jesus, when you go with the power of the Holy Spirit, miracles happen. The sick are healed, demons are cast out. What of God says, where they saw the apostles laying hands upon the people, miracles happening, laying hands upon the people, and they receive the Holy Spirit. This man took out some money, said, sell me also the power. When I pray the people, they must receive the Holy Spirit. Peter said to him, go and perish with your money. You are full of gall. You are full of bitter gall. He is used to buying. You think you can buy the power of God. The power of God cannot be bought. The power of darkness can buy it. But the power of God is not for sale. The power of darkness can
We are not allowed to power of the Holy Spirit.
To operate in our churches, miracles and signs will happen. If you see these days, they are faking miracles.
It is because
believers
or
the leaders of this generation are no longer trusting the power of the Holy Spirit.
We
take the Holy Spirit, put him aside, used our own power. They are trying to use other power to attract people. No.
The
Holy Spirit can do better. Glory to Jesus. That you fake miracles. When the Holy Spirit spoke to me,
he
said, you can allow me. You can see miracles. You can allow me. Somebody can come without a leg, it will grow same time. You can allow me. Somebody can come without eyes, with no eyes, eyes can appear same time. Somebody can come without a hand, a hand can grow at the same time. By the power of the Holy Spirit, I can raise 5 days being dead. I, Holy Spirit, can allow me. But in these days,
but
the Holy Spirit never allowed it. We are lazy to pray. We are the brother of God. People have been fake
miracles.
They are fake miracles. Trying to attract people. They fake miracles. They bribe people. They sit on a wheelchair. As if when I pray you rise, they fake miracles. They are attracting people. What happened? Where is the Holy Spirit? When are faking miracles? We are praying for the resurrection of the Holy Spirit in our churches.
They
are faking prophecies to attract the crowd. But the time now that the Holy Spirit come back to our churches. The Holy Spirit come back. The Holy Spirit come back.
They are
saying somebody somebody who died in the rose. Look at that person. No one was dead. You look at that
thing.
This person was breathing. Going to the phone in the box. Then he's breathing.
Because
that is games. Where is the Holy Spirit? We apologize, Lord. We apologize, Holy Spirit. We are not
playing.
Put the Holy Spirit, put them aside.
We
fake miracles. Do wrong things to attract the crowd. To deceive the people of God. The time now that the church must go back to its position. Must go back to seek the face of the Lord. The Holy Spirit can do miracles that are genuine.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
The Bible says, Philip
went
down to Samaria, preached Christ, miracles happened, people were healed, demons came out of people, miracles happened. The Bible says, preached Christ, never went to Samaria with faith products, preached Christ, never went to Samaria with salt. Preach Christ.
Never
went to Samaria.
Carrying holy water.
Preach Christ. All these things, put them aside. All these games. Deceive the people of God. Somebody was putting the salt in the mouth.
To
the child of God.
Tell
the salt so bitter.
Put the
salt of the fire. They are playing with the people. But ask the Holy Spirit. Must come back. And show the world that the miracles happened. Miracles happened. Real miracles happening. When the Holy Spirit is there in churches. He never went to Samaria. With holy water. With his washo.
Yeah, the washo.
They are busy now propagating his wash. They are selling oil. Never went there to sell oil. He went there to preach Christ. Let us go back to the gospel. The real gospel. Let us go back to the gospel of the apostles. To the word of God. That is not mixed with anything. Let us preach Christ. Let us preach Jesus. People be healed. People be saved. People be set free. Never went there. Telling all these things. As you are carrying them. You have them in your bag. Some of them under your bag. That's not the gospel. Like with the people of God. It's not in the word. You're busy carrying things. You're carrying his wash. You get salt. What are these things?
The
Holy Spirit is
amazed.
We have put him aside. We have stifled him. They are deceiving the people of God. When the church can rise,
our
believers can arise and pray. Pray for the Holy Spirit. May he come to the church. May he come into our lives. Miracles will happen. Without all these things, without all these faith products, without all this wash, without all these souls, and preach Christ, miracles will happen. The dead will rise, blindness will open, dumb will speak, the deaf will hear by the power of the Holy Spirit. There is no need for faking miracles. There is no need for bribing people to pretend and fake miracles because they want to draw the crowd or to draw people. What shall we say to God? As we are playing around with the gospel, we rebuke that spirit. We ask the Holy Spirit, may he come back to churches. Holy Spirit must come back to our lives.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
When you check these days, even the witch doctors are playing around. You can see that this one is a witch doctor. Then for him to stay there, now they've diverted. They carry the Bible. They are preaching also that confuses the people. That person is done for sorcery. They are playing with the people of God.
They've
got the Bible, they are preaching.
Help us, Lord. Help us, Jehovah. Help us, Holy Spirit. Help us, Spirit of the Lord. We pray for the restoration of the Holy Spirit. Bible says, when they heard that Samaria had received the word, the word of God says, they sent the apostles to go and pray for them to receive the Holy Spirit. I pray for you. Everybody who is listening to me, receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. Everywhere where you are listening from, receive the power from on high. Receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Word of God says,
our God anointed Jesus
with power
and with the Holy Ghost.
I pray today,
may
come upon you. I pray today, may the Lord anoint you with the Holy Spirit. Power from on high has come upon your life.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
Word of God says,
if the Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in us, He shall quicken our mortal bodies. He shall give life to our dying bodies. Moya wavusa uKristu Jesu obafileyo umehlala phakathi kwethu ngoba umzimba wethu ulithempeli likamoya loyingcwele. Akomvumele emlaleli umoya loyingcwele ehlale empilweni yakho. Akomvumele umoya loyingcwele ahlale phakathi kwakho. Nithi iBhayibheli uzoyiphilisa imizimba yethu efayo. Ngibona kunabantu abangilaleyo namhlanje abavula iy'nhliziyo zabo abathi ngiyamdinga umoya ingcwele, abathi moya ingcwele ngiyakwamukela, take control empilweni yami. Ngibona umoya ingcwele bakangena empilweni yakho. Ngibona ukufa kuyaphuma. Ngibona umoya ingcwele uyakuphilisa kulokufa okuthiwa kulapheki. Ngibona umoya ingcwele uyakhulula.
Liberating you.
Iloko kuzokwenzeka.
That's what will happen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Ngegama lika Jesu.
Ngiyakhulekela.
I pray for you.
Yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Holy Spirit.
Ngiyakhulekela.
I pray for you.
Yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Holy Ghost.
Ngiyakhulekela.
I pray for you.
Yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Holy Spirit.
Moya wamandla. Moya weqiniso.
Spirit of truth.
Moya loyingcwele.
Holy Spirit.
Lithizwi likaNkulunkulu.
Holy Spirit says,
semiyothandaza. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There is freedom. There is deliverance. Lapho umoya kaNkulunkulu ekhona, ukhona inkululeko.
There is liberty.
Lapho umoya ingcwele khona, ukhona inkululeko.
There is freedom.
Vumela umoya ingcwele
ukuthi
take control. Bafundisi asimvumele umoya ingcwele emabandleni. Isikhathi sakhe lesi bafuna ukubona imanga nesibonakaliso. Bafuna ukubona abantu befakaza izinto ezinkulu, izimanga uNkulunkulu obenzela zona kuzokwenzeka uma siyovumela umoya loyingcwele ukuthi take control. Siyobona abantu bekhululeka, bekhululwa ngamandla kamoya loyingcwele. Siyobona amadimoni ephuma ebantwini, amadimoni astubborn, abantu bekhululeka, bekhululwa ngamandla kamoya
loyingcwele.
Kamoya loyingcwele.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Mandla sezulwini.
Power from on high.
Mandla kamoya ingcwele.
Power of the Holy Ghost.
Yamukela inkululeko namhlanje.
Receive a freedom.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Ngegama lika Jesu.
Yamukela inkululeko namhlanje.
Receive a freedom.
Yamukela ukuphila namhlanje.
Receive healing.
Khululeka kulokufa. Khululeka kuleyiqalekiso.
Nanga
umoya loyingcwele. Uyahamba hamba njengoba ngikhuluma nje. Hamba ngama
airwaves.
Uyahamba hamba njengoba ngikhuluma nje. Uyangena emakhaya. Ngibona umoya ingcwele. Uvuselela isipho. Akupha
that it gave you.
Ngibona amandla ayabuya empilweni yakho. Moya loyingcwele uthinta impilo yakho. Ingakho bengikhuthaza abangcwele on Sunday ukuthi kuleli viki ake sifunde incwadi yezenzo. Nawe ongilalele ake ufunde incwadi yezenzo, khona okuzokwenzeka empilweni yakho. Ukuyifunde nje leli viki lonke, funda incwadi yezenzo from chapter 1 until we chapter yokugcina. Ukubona amandla kamoya ingcwele mawehla, ukubona imisebenzi kamoya loyingcwele, khona okuzokwenzeka empilweni yakho. Kunamandla azokuthinta mzalwane.
Child of God,
yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Holy Spirit.
Yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Holy Ghost.
Yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Holy Spirit.
Yamukela umoya ingcwele.
Receive the Spirit of the Lord.
Vumela umoya ingcwele.
Allow the Holy Spirit.
Lorobo shatala
bayo. Yira bobo shakala maya.
Indala bakho shatala bayo.
Yira bobo shikira.